Wake up call, roll call, where you at? We here. Hey, so some of you gonna know what I'm talking about when I say this, man. Sometimes I'm finding out. I've always known this, but now more than ever, sometimes you have to go into the room and close the door, right? So the thing is that I've never been adverse to the fast life. And when I say fast life, I'm not just talking about like selling drugs. Done that too, right? But I'm talking about just in general. If you know me, you know, man, I move a million miles a minute. Nonstop, go, 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 go. And I've never ducked the challenge. I ain't never ducked no fade, right? The more difficult the terrain, or the greater the obstacle, or the bigger the challenge, like that's me, because I am like that guy. I enjoy a good challenge. Give me something that's gonna push me, make me work harder, right? But I'm finding out, you know, so yesterday, man, was, I found myself in a couple of conundrums, a couple of challenges. And here's one thing I'll say before I continue is that it would behoove me to put the very thing that I want to do in life ahead of the person, the one person that I swore I couldn't wait to come and protect, right? And so what I've ended up finding out is that sometimes you got to slow down. You know, I found myself in a situation where I presented with some really good opportunities, but these opportunities come with big time obstacles and big time hurdles and big time challenges to bring it to fruition. Now, in a previous life, what I would do is I would just jump right into it and I wouldn't really think about the particular negative ramifications. I wouldn't think it all the way through. I'm like, oh, that's not a challenge. That's an opportunity. This is an opportunity to grow. If anybody can overcome that hurdle, anybody can jump over it or get through the obstacle course or navigate the terrain, it's this guy, right? But I realized that at this junction, the best thing that I can do is go to the room and close the door. I gotta stop and I gotta pray on this one, because maybe it's not so much God saying, I'm gonna put these obstacles in your way to see how well you do in overcoming them. Maybe that's not what he's trying to tell me. Maybe what he's trying to tell me is I'm putting these obstacles in your way as a barrier trying to stop you. I put so many stop signs in your path to say, stop, don't keep going. And it would be a fool to keep going. So sometimes you got to go into the room and close the door in order to get that level of discernment that you need to make the right and proper decision before you proceed. And so I think that's the difference in where I find my life in 2021 versus the preceding years of 2015, right? Because I cannot afford at this junction in my life to proceed without caution and make the wrong moves. Even though my heart and my intentions are in the right place, I'm looking to pursue an opportunity that will directly align me with my purpose in life. But what I need to find out is this the season for that? Am I in the season of harvesting, or am I in the season of wait? Am I in the season of cultivating, or am I in the season of spreading the seeds? What's the season? And so what I have to do is I gotta stop, I gotta go into the room, and I gotta close the door. Don't be afraid to pray and take it to God, man, because he can give you the answers. Only he can directly guide you. What does it say? Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding, and all your ways submit to him, and he will make your path straight. That's right. It's the 4:30 wake up. Roll call, where you at?